Let me kill a day. We don't want to kill ourselves to be waiting. Without waiting. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Beatrice, and if you're not new here, welcome back. For today's episode of Aproko, we're going to talk about Mr. P, okay? But before we get into the video, please like this video if you enjoyed it. And subscribe if you haven't. And you can follow me on Instagram. So, Mr. P, Mr. Prodigan, as he calls himself. Apparently the P doesn't stand for Peter or P square. It stands for Prodigan. Okay. So he recently was on live, IG live with Daddy Freeze, and they were talking about, you know, his COVID-19 situation, because recently he revealed to us, general public, that he was he tested positive for COVID-19, him, his wife and his kids. And I think now his wife and his kids, they're over it. I'm not sure. But basically, he came on live and he was trying to tell, you know, the trolls and everybody that is doubting him if it's true or not, that he's not here to convince anybody. He doesn't owe anyone receipts. And, you know, I'm going to maybe insert the video where he's saying all these things somewhere around here.
See, when you call me for this step, what did I tell you? I'm not come to tell myself I really catch this. I really catch a more. So I don't go feed that side try convince you now. I don't need to show that receipt. If I get HIV, I go ask me that show that receipt. No. That's why they say
And basically he was saying, yeah, you guys can basically F off, you know, and he was dragging his trolls and bragging. Just last year he bought 3 cars. You know, because it's a very vital information apparently. And you know, also he revealed that he's dropping an album pretty soon, if not in less than 2 months. And Daddy Freeze also took this opportunity, you know, this conversation that they were having, you know, to kind of, I guess, redeem himself from the comments he made pertaining the Hush Puppy situation. And in a way trying to make it seem like the backlash he got wasn't deserved. So basically he was like, and you know what, nobody's going to talk about the good deeds I've done, and it's not trending, you know, because people at the end of the day, they only like negative stuff, and they do not know what I did. I did so much and everything. And he was just going on and on and on about how, you know, his church, I didn't know he had a church, helped the church members. He was sending 5,000 naira to them for 3 weeks, or what did he say? We appreciate it, but at the end of the day, God used your vessel to do so. You understand? You don't take credit for good deeds. It's glory be to God. Basically, so I don't know why he was bragging that much about it. At the end of the day, when you do enough good, it will shine. Nobody can stop it. So we don't need you to say it, you know. If you were going as hard as you were for Hush Puppy in your good deeds and everything, it would definitely show. Like, they did not burn anybody to stop the shine of whatever good deeds you're doing. So moving along. So Mr. P was basically, and also what they were talking about, loyalty, and basically he was saying that if Hush Puppy was his friend, he'd still visit him in prison, and that's called loyalty. And if him one day were to be locked up, his wife would come and see him. Like, if God forbid his enemy were to be locked up in prison, his wife would come and see him, definitely, because it's loyalty. Let me explain something to you. If you get locked up, you are not entitled to your wife coming to see you. Your wife is not the one that committed the crime. You understand? So because you are locked up, she too have to be locked up. You understand? It's like she's in prison too. So her life will now stop because you decided to make a stupid decision. Where is correlation? You understand? That's the risk you take. That's the thing, you know, that's the consequence that come with you acting that way. So Hush Puppy can definitely expect for his guys or his friends to drop him in the blink of an eye, because of that's what come with your crime. You understand? That is the consequence you have to face. You understand what I'm saying? Because you are forgiven for a crime you've done, or you know, let's say you cheated on your girlfriend and she forgives you, that doesn't mean she's going to be in a relationship with you again. No, you still have to face the consequences of what you did. Every action has a reaction. You understand? So that's what comes with it. Some people, there's levels to this consequence of a thing. Some people, they'll lose everything, and some people they still have the grace of having some things left intact. But not everybody has that privilege. You understand? So I feel like it's unfair to expect your loved ones to be the same, because the situation is completely different. Some people's loyalty is not elastic. You understand? Some people actually have boundaries. So don't expect that from it. Nobody owe you ish. Just like you said, you don't owe anybody ish. Nobody owes you ish as well. So you can just hope for the best in situations like that and just be grateful for what's left of your life after that. Okay? Tell me what you guys think about what Mr. P. Tell me what you guys think about what Mr. P said and Daddy Freeze. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.